Today's story is about a faithful man who put his life in God's hands. King Darius was the king of Babylon. Babylon was a huge kingdom with 120 provinces. King Darius couldn't lead all of these provinces on his own, so he appointed a high officer for each province. The king also chose three governors to lead the high officers and protect the king's interests. One of the governors was Daniel, a faithful man of God. Daniel prayed to God every day. Three times a day, he would go to his window and pray. Dear God, thank you for all of your blessings. God was with Daniel. And soon, King Darius noticed that Daniel was a smarter, kinder, and better leader than everyone in the kingdom. King Darius thought, perhaps it would be best for the kingdom if I put Daniel in charge of everyone. The other leaders heard this, and they were not happy. They didn't like the idea of Daniel being better than them. I know, let's spy on Daniel and see if he does anything bad. Yes, and if we catch him, let's tell the king and he will punish him. They spied on Daniel, watching his every move. But they couldn't find any fault in Daniel. Daniel was faithful, totally reliable, and trustworthy. This isn't working. What should we do? We know that he prays to his God every day. Let's try using that against him. The governors and all the high officers went to the king. Long live King Darius! You're the most powerful. To celebrate your greatness, we must come up with a law. In the next 30 days, everybody should worship you and you alone. Any person who prays to any other god will be thrown into a lion's den. Darius had no idea that they were plotting to have Daniel killed. He loved the idea of being treated like a god. So King Darius signed the law. When Daniel heard about the law, he simply went home. Just as he does every day, he prayed to God by his window. Three times a day. God, you alone are the King of all kings, the one true God. Thank you for all your goodness. The governors went immediately to the king. Did you not sign a law that any person who worships any other god will be thrown into a den of lions? Yes, I have. It is an official law which cannot be reversed. Daniel has broken the law. Three times a day, Daniel would go to his window and pray to his God. The king didn't know what to do. He wanted to save Daniel, but it couldn't be reversed. He worried about Daniel the whole day, but couldn't do anything about it. Your Majesty, the law cannot be reversed. Arrest Daniel now. So the king gave an order to arrest Daniel and throw him into the lion's den. As they closed the den, Darius said to Daniel, "May your God keep you safe from any harm." The lion's den was sealed. King Darius was so worried. He couldn't sleep nor eat. The lions in the den are starving. Surely they will eat anybody thrown in that den. The whole night he was thinking about Daniel. Very early the next day, the king hurried to the lion's den. With tears in his eyes, he shouted, "Daniel, servant of the living God, was your God able to rescue you from the lions? Long live the king! My God sent the angels to shut the lion's mouth. I am safe. My God thinks I am innocent, and I have not done anything wrong with you." The king was so happy. He ordered Daniel to be lifted out of the den. And sure enough, not a scratch was found in him. for God protected him. All of you who want to have Daniel killed, you should be the ones thrown into the lion's den. And as they were thrown, the hungry lions ate them before they could even hit the ground. King Darius saw a miracle! Daniel was alive! And he wanted the whole world to know it. Everyone throughout my kingdom should tremble with fear before the God of Daniel. He is the living God and will endure forever. His kingdom will never be destroyed and his rule will not end. He rescues and saves his people. He performs miracles in heaven and on earth. He has rescued Daniel from the sharp teeth of the lion. Daniel could have closed his windows or simply pray silently in his heart. But he didn't allow the circumstances to change him. Instead, he used it to show everyone who God is. Richard Baxter wrote, "Lord, it belongs not to my care, whether I die or live, to love or serve thee is my share, and this thy grace must give." Open your windows today. Let it be a reminder to pray. Once, twice, thrice, no matter how many times a day, let him in your heart, and forever let him stay. See you next time. Bye-bye. Now comes the bloopers, Daddy. Okay, is this already recording? Okay, let's do it again, baby. Ta-da! Because I'm in a silly mood today, you know? And come on! Babylon is a huge kingdom with 120 provinces. King Darius couldn't lead again. And go. So he appoints. Every funny thing I do, put it in the blue first.